Is this how you collect all your samples?
That's how we do it.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Valley of the Last Dinosaurs. Today, I'm sitting with my colleague, Dr. Antoine Bercovici.
Hi everyone.
And Antoine's a postdoctoral fellow at the Smithsonian Institute.
Yes.
And he's here collecting samples for his paleobotanical research. So break that big word for me down. What's paleobotany all about?
So paleontology is the study of animal life on Earth, fossil animal life, and paleobotany is the study of fossil plant life.
Okay, fossil plants, got it. So do you actually find lots of fossil plants out here?
Well, actually, for the past 30 years, people have been finding a tremendous amount of fossil plants, beautiful leaf impressions from all over those rocks. And there is also wood that you can find.
So leaves and wood, and I think I've seen a few leaf fossils, but I don't really have a trained eye yet. What else, what other kind of plant fossils do you stumble upon out here?
Well, there is a kind of plant fossil that's everywhere here that we cannot see because it's microscopic. It's fossil pollen.
Oh, really? Tiny pollen actually makes a fossil?
Absolutely.
That's so cool. So I don't think I've ever seen any of that. What's how would I know if I'd seen that?
Well, as I said, it's everywhere in microscopic, so you cannot see it in the field, but you can take sample here, back to the lab, process it, and then look at it under a microscope.
Oh, that's so cool. So that must be why you're digging this huge trench. Every time I see you, you've got a spade in your hand and you're out here digging these huge, tall holes.
Absolutely. So the problem here is that we're working in soft rock. Those are not very hard rock, like granite. We can basically remove it with your hand, it just crumbles. And erosion actually smear all those contact. And we actually need to sample some very fresh rock in order to avoid any sort of contamination.
I see, so that's why you're cutting in here to look for the actual layers of sediment that were
Absolutely.
Laid down, in the order that they were laid down.
Absolutely.
So Tyler told me a little bit about your research and said that actually the fossil pollen is very important for finding the KT boundary. How does that work?
So it is because just like the dinosaurs went extinct and other animals went extinct too, plants suffered mass extinction at the end of the Cretaceous. And plants produce pollen spores, so by looking at the pollen spore record, you can track this extinction as well. Now the great thing about pollen spores, I said, is that they're microscopic, they're very small. So you can find millions of them in this outcrop and sample them at a centimeter scale, every centimeter by centimeter, and find the point where actually you see this change in flora that corresponds to the mass extinction event.
Oh wow, so when the ecosystem changed with the extinction, you can see that recorded in all the tiny little pollen grains in a little piece of rock this big.
That's right, you just flip the switch, plants get extinct, and in that chip of rock like this one that you just picked up, I can find probably 100,000 pollen grains in spores, so there's a lot of data right there.
Oh man, so I guess the resolution is a lot better when you're dealing with tiny little microscopic fossils.
Yes.
A dinosaur is a huge thing, meters and meters in length, but with the pollen, you're able to pick, I guess, what precision level do you have, a centimeter?
That's, yeah, if you can get down to 1 centimeter and pick out the boundary.
You can find the actual boundary.
And then we have a timeline across all those holes that we're digging out that indicates this point of extinction. And
across the entire field area.
That's what we're tracking.
Oh my gosh, that's so cool. So if you haven't sampled all this yet, but do you have a guess where you might think the KT boundary is in the section that we're sitting in right now?
Yes, well, we've been actually digging a lot of those trenches all across, and in some of those buttes, actually, I have actually processed that. And it seems like you're actually sitting right on the KT boundary right there. So
wait, right here underneath
right
me?
There, yep.
No way, that's so cool. All that crazy destruction and mass extinction right here in a fine layer. And we wouldn't know with the naked eye. You have to use those microscopes back
you
in your office.
You have to do that, yes.
So you'll take bags of this sample material back to the lab, and you'll be looking at them, I guess, all winter.
Yes.
Trying to make sense of how many of these trenches have you dug out here in this little area that we've been in all summer?
Oh, probably a dozen, yeah. Oh.
Yep. So a lot of microscope slides to look at, hundreds of thousands of individual pollen grains to check out. And it sounds like a big project, but we really appreciate you taking a minute to tell us about your research today. And you guys at home, check back in with us this week. We're going to show you some of the images that Antoine has shared with us from his lab through the microscope, looking at what looks like dirt right here to the naked eye. There's a whole universe of tiny plant fossils right here, right?
Yep, and the good thing is that you're not running out of dirt here. It's all over the place, so.
That's good, yeah, there seems to be no shortage of dirt here. I think I've got plenty on my pair of jeans back there you could probably sample. But anyway, thanks for tuning in, guys. Well, you know, come on back at the end of the week and we'll check back in with Antoine here in the Valley of the Last Dinosaurs. Later.